like a Walmart. We got the for the wrong sport. You know, you know. If you know about the port, though it's supposed to be awkward. If you know, you know. That's the reason we for circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know.
I like when birds come out. Sounds like I see it in that. Hey, I'm on your turf again. This, that.
Yeah.
You from the back of the.
Yeah.
I got a girl, Brad.
Yeah.
She go to battle. Yeah. LED load of the tech.
Yeah.
I go in back of the.
Yeah.
They all from that.
Yeah.
My diamonds, they all look at. This, that.
Yeah.
I go to bed on bed.
Yeah.
I got the demon on flex. Huh.
Yeah.
I got a in the back. Haters, they talk to chat.
Check.
They step on the rock, don't matter.
Man.
Find out where you lay at, I got the lurking, and they hate cats. Pockets, they fat, I got the from the block and they spamming, they know what banks at. I got the work on the avenue, they know what tanks at. I got the that live in the mansion, they know what at. I got some that's up in the jail, they know what at. I came on top of the building, yeah, my we had a plan. We came on top of the building, yeah, my we never ran. Down there, thought that I had a fan. Oh, hey, any 10 o'clock, got a flight out, yeah, I'm going back out to Japan. I got two Billy truck and a bitch door when it's land. Bruce Wayne, I'm Batman. Batman, I'm best man. I got my best man. I got my. I go to hotels when I step out, yeah, your boy got a doorman. I go to nightclubs with a. Yeah, they call me the madman. I ain't no madman. I just go crazy, man. Ball hard, can't face, man. Choppers, rip wasteland. This what happens when you give it a taste life and you give it a wasteland. This what happens when you give it a fake life and then.
Coach, thank you much. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Los Angeles Rams. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Play action here on first down. And incomplete to open things up. Robert Woods, former USC man, the intended target. That'll bring up second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Second and 10. Goff again. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A Ram first down as Goff finds Kupp.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
On first down, Goff working the middle here. That's complete to Everett, the tight end. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven. Now the first carry here for Todd Gurley. And there is nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down in the backfield. It's a loss of two, now third down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game. So what do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
And he finds a man with a crossing route. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion. And a nice start there to the aerial attack to pick up the first.
And I think preseason is officially over now. Getting into the groove of the regular season, that's a great way to get started. First drive of the season, what a nice completion.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. On first down, it's Gurley. And a short gain down to about the 33. Sean Williams had time in on the stop.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second down, here's Goff. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. The linebacker, Preston Brown, there to knock that one away.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one.
Into heavy traffic, and oh, he coughed it up, and the Bengals have recovered it. Former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. Space to maneuver at the 40. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. A great effort there. 72 yards. And the Bengals are going to take a first quarter lead. A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good, and it's now a 7-0 game. Bullock out now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Rams offense now making their way out to take over. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to let this go deep, back over the middle, and nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, second down. Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Now Bortles on the bootleg. Flushed out right. Throw right side is into the hands of his tight end Everett. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
Green 80. Green 80.
Now a play fake. Bortles. A bullet throw, but incomplete. Before the game, they were running the route tree about as efficiently and effectively as we could have possibly imagined, but sometimes the passes just go awry.
Yeah, let's face it. When you're running the route tree in pregame, you don't have defenders breathing down your neck. You don't have defensive backs making plays on the football. Hard to replicate the intensity of the game in pregame.
On is the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away. Taken in at the 22. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Bengals will take over here first and 10. Now this Bengals offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it? Big-time jaunt. Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. A tale of two extremes. First carry, he went for a bundle. His second goes backward.
And how many times have we seen that happen? Because you get that big carry, and you come back, and you're all fired up, and sometimes you force a run a little bit, right? Trying to break off that big carry again, and instead, it works opposite.
They'll set up to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup, and that's going to bring up a third down.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
They'll look to throw. And incomplete on the deep ball.
How about this offense already feeling good about themselves with a touchdown already in their first drive? They've certainly come out firing, even though that one was incomplete.
With the 7-0 lead, more apt to take a shot like that downfield?
Hey, you're one to the good. Go ahead and try and press your advantage.
Punting now is Huber as he sends it away. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And things haven't started so well for this side. Two drives, two punts.
So now you've got to start looking not just at play calling, but which guy's going to step forward and say, okay, let's get this thing done. Because within that unit of 11, sometimes one guy can make a big-time play and break through the barrier.
They'll start out on the ground with Gurley. Nice move on the play, but he will be brought down shy of the 15. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
On second down, here's Bortles. And Cooks hands it over the middle. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. First catch of the new season for him, and he picks up the first. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
An incomplete pass on first down, that leads to a second and 10. Now they'll pitch it back to Gurley, and they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. They'll wind up losing 3, and now it's third down.
Footing's definitely going to be an issue, because it's tough to make those quick cuts that you're used to making on a soggy track. In fact, a Hall of Fame runner once told me, cut on your heels in this type of weather. Gives you better balance.
Back live now to begin the second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's the Rams with a football to get us going. They do, however, have a tough third and long coming up. It's a loss of 11 on the play, and that'll bring up fourth down. Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he's able to get it out of there, and this is a pretty good kick. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it, he loses it, somehow the ball finds its way back to him.
Atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. And he'll get him a little bit of breathing room across the 5 to the 6 yard line. There to make the tackle, Samson Abuka.
And while they hope to continue this drive, it's really already mission accomplished. They've given enough space now that they have to punt the ball. They've done so with that first run.
A little more room here on 2nd and 6 from the 6. On 2nd down, here's Mixon. And he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
Well, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Now on 1st down, he'll drop to throw it. That's complete to John Ross. The Red Sea parts, and there he goes. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. A big play there. 88 yards. And the Bengals add on to their lead. And Charles, I had an offensive coordinator tell me one time that they design every play to score. I don't know how true that is. I mean, he had to run a long way after that catch. Heck of a play.
I think that when he was telling you that, he was designing run after catch in every play.
I mean, that's the only way to put it in there, and that's what we got on that one. Nice catch, an even better run for big yardage.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 2nd and 11.
Tight,
here we go, fellas. Here we go. Here's Goff now on 2nd down. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on 1st and 10. Now gone. Steps away. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And they will set up shop with outstanding field position in the red zone at the 17-yard line. And maybe that one caused by the weather. Of course, the rain coming down
Charles, can you maybe, when you're carrying that football, grip it too tight in the rain?
I think that you can, and it's such a delicate balance, too, because when you grip it so tight, sometimes it'll slip out from your body. You squeeze it too hard, and it'll pop out on its own. I've actually had running backs talk to me about that, that when they've tried too hard, even in perfect conditions, the ball gets away from them. You've got to find a good balance, carrying it firmly, yet at the same time under control.
They'll set up a throw. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. His big tight end, Tyler Eifert, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
There are a good number of coaches that anytime they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play, it was batted down.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Looking for Boyd, and he's got him. Touchdown, Bengals. Tyler Boyd from 19 yards away. And the Bengals are able to grow their lead. Now Bullock to add the extra point. Bullock good on the extra point. And it's now 21 to nothing. Bullock out now to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Now on second down, this is Gurley. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Goff now looks to throw. And he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively. But instead it just brings up fourth down. Here's Johnny Hecker now. As he's on to punt for L.A. He steps into this one and this is a rocket. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The Bengals getting set to go. They are clicking on all cylinders. They seem to be just scoring at will right now, and that's why they've opened up this big lead.
You know, we always talk about getting into the zone, and all athletes are seeking that, aren't they? Where everything is working for them, every move they make works, it clicks, and they are on point right now.
Yeah, they are in that zone that you're talking about. Give them three on first down, it'll set up a second and 7. Rattle. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to the City of Angels after this timeout. Now second and 7 from the 23. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. Tackle there by Clay Matthews.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
They'll look to throw here. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Mixon with a first down carry. And they'll stop him right on the midfield stripe. The tackle there by John Johnson.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And the pitch goes to Mixon. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory. On the stop was Aaron Donald. 2 yards on the first down carry and then followed up by 2 yards on the second down carry.
Well, that's definitely not going to be enough to get the job done. Wasn't the expression 3 yards in a cloud of dust?
Now they're going to need 6 on third down to keep the drive going. The Bengals on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6.
He'll drop to throw. And this one is incomplete.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Here's Kevin Huber now as he'll kick it away for the second time. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. So now here are the Rams as their offense comes back out. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure it's something.
A big seam, and he might go all the way. Touchdown, LA! A big play there. An 80-yard touchdown. And the Rams are able to cut into this lead.
The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take it to the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. A lot of football, full half to be played.
A little under 30 seconds to go. We'll see how they play it here on 1st and 10. They'll come out throwing here on 1st down. Over the middle, that's caught by Ross. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. As the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for 1st and 10. Back to throw now on 1st down. To the left side here for Eifert. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. And now we won't see a play on 1st down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. How about the rookie in his NFL debut? Looking sharp. It's 1st and 10. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And incomplete. He dropped it in the end zone. So after the incompletion on 1st, now 2nd and 10. He'll look to throw. And he's going to go down. He sacked back at the 24. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. This is a 40-yard attempt from the left hash. And that is no good. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend, as we'll send you eastward to Orlando. Standing by with that EA Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coachman. Take it away, Coach. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. This is fielded at the goal line. He's got a convoy, and he might be gone. The 20, 10, and he will score. Touchdown, Cincinnati, as his guys are in for six, and the Bengals add on to their lead. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind, because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost...
My have an all-white rank. Couldn't hit if Pat ain't. Lanes can't call and you lame. You had it and you lost it, all the shine. I can buy a Billy, don't talk to me. For a show 150, don't talk to me. You ain't never helped your mans, don't talk to me. You just follow all the trends, don't talk to me. I set the bar, I'm the bar. Look in the sky, I'm a star. I don't fall in love, cause I be loving, cause I be loving. They ain't like my shirt, it's a large. I don't care, I crush a ghost. Got two cribs in two states, I be doing the most. I got white folks money that I won't blow. And if you ask why, cause the white folks don't. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. The type of money you gon' need to sight. The type of money you gon' need to buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank.
Everything proper, no propaganda. Tropicana, gold yard, bandana. Big, big, a lot of like Santa. Through a birthday party in a phantom. Big, big, like a dinosaur did it. And you know, no, shining like acrylic. Yeah, yeah, I had cornrows. I can see you hang with the door closed. Now I'm looking for a glove with a sparkle on it. And my got chocolate on it. Big bank, take small. Bank account on some tall. Attitude on some. Bank roll on what it do, boo. He had the rule at five, and if I ain't did it yet, I'll try.